Hello, this is Todd from Manifest My Wellness, and this is another Manifestation Minute. If chronic pain has been a part of your life, as it has mine for the last 12 years, then you also live with anxiety. And that's the focus of today's minute. Anxiety is crippling. It shows up at work. It shows up in your relationships. It shows up in the middle of the night. It wakes you out of a dead sleep. This kind of anxiety can bring on panic attacks that actually have sent me to the hospital at least twice. I was in a toxic job at the time, and I was having between 3 and 5 panic attacks a week. And I had to figure out how to manage them because I couldn't continue to take off work every time I had a panic attack. So I had to figure it out. What helped me get through my anxiety, and still does, is taking control of breathing. Breathing is a critical aspect of controlling the physiology. And with breathing techniques, I was able to control my panic attacks. So what kind of breathing works? Well, box breathing is one that works. The military uses it. Nurses use it. A lot of high-stress jobs understand the use of breathing and learning how to breathe. And box breathing is also called square breathing. And studies have shown that box breathing actually helps regulate the autonomic nervous system and can be used effectively for pain control. So focusing on that breath is important. The first several times you start doing breathing exercises, what happens is you may start to get dizzy. You're changing how you take in air, and it can make you feel dizzy. If you push through that dizziness, your body will regulate itself. Boxed breathing, or squared breathing, is where you breathe in for a count of 4, you then hold it for 4, and then you breathe out for 4, and you hold it for 4. I'll link something down below that lets you know what that is. Another form of breathing that's also very effective is to breathe in for a count of 5 and then breathe out for a count of 5. And you can sustain this all day long. One word of caution: if you've been medically diagnosed with a breathing issue, please adjust this to work for you. Do not hold yourself and get so dizzy that you pass out. So adjust it. Breathe in for 2 instead of 5, or breathe in for 3. Find a way to just get in touch with breathing. That's an important part of healing. Number 2, when you have anxiety and you're having an attack, you need to find a place to get away. And at home, that might be easier, it may not be. You got to find a quiet place. You can also isolate yourself effectively with noise-canceling headphones. Bluetooth headphones are amazing. So you need to be able to listen to something. Get some music into your head as well. Find something that either makes you happy or something that you find soothing. One aspect of listening that really works is to go out and find a sound for yourself. What you do when you do that is you actually have an emotional connection with the sound, and you've put movement in it as well. Go record a sound feature, something that you like to listen to, whether someone's got a water feature in their yard or maybe there's one in the house. Just record it and then just play it on loop. That added emotional connection to that sound is really very effective. Lastly, if you want to manage anxiety, you've got to put in your schedule time to get alone. If you're at work, you can get in your car. Find time away from the tasks that you're doing. At least 5 minutes on every hour. If you can find 5 to 10 minutes to get away from the office into a place that's secluded, put on your headphones, listen to your playlist, and do those breathing exercises. Just make them a part of what you do every day. If you don't take time for yourself, you can't effectively give to others. If you found this helpful, leave a comment and subscribe. Thank you.